हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी। नमस्कार विद्यार्थी मित्र मैत्रिणींनो, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द पेज नंबर 166 3.6 ग्रुप डिस्कशन। देर इज द ऐक्टिविटी ऑफ ग्रुप डिस्कशन, आइस ब्रेकर्स एक्टिविटी। सो फर्स्ट वी सी इन इंट्रोडक्शन व्हाट इज मीन बाय ग्रुप डिस्कशन। अ ग्रुप डिस्कशन इज अ सुपरवाइज्ड कम्युनिकेशन एक्टिविटी वेयर इन मल्टीपल पार्टिसिपेंट्स एंगेज देमसेल इन एक्सचेंजिंग व्यूज एंड ओपिनियंस ऑन अ गिवन टॉपिक। सो व्हाइल प्रेजेंटिंग their views and opinion, the participant also remain receptive to the views and opinions of other participants. There may be arguments and counter as argument in a positive way. So similarly, some opinions are supported and some others are opposed. Some opinions are supported and some others are opposed. The general mood of the discussion decides whether the group is in favor or against the contentious issued subject and topic. So finally, under the supervision of the evaluator, the members conclude the discussion on a general as a consensus. So there is the activity of group discussion. You see, group discussion is important in our life. Group discussion is important in our life. There are four skills. We know about that. There are four skills. Speaking, first listening, second speaking. L-E-S-R-W, listening, speaking, reading and writing. So first we listen the word and then we speak the same words from our birth. So listen actively and attentively with comprehension and respond accordingly to the lecture, talks, as conversation, as news bulletins, interviews, debates, and discussion. So enjoy critically, appreciate a variety of literature as well as recorded lectures as podcast, songs, movies, skits, and plays. Second, you see speaking. So use English fluently, correctly in day-to-day communication. And that is the possible when you practice very well. So recite poems with correct pronunciation, intonation and stress. Recite poems with pronunciation, intonation and stress. So speak with acceptable pace and pronunciation. So speak as coherently, fluently, confidently, intelligibly on a given topic for a reasonable period of time with appropriate gesture. So body language and intonation. Respond to questions orally. So make oral presentation on a given topic. Narrate, read aloud the stories, events, experience in standard English. So express effectively in a group discussion, that is the most important. Reflect in a group discussion. Express effectively in a group discussion. Interviews, debates, elocution and extempore and speech competition. So use digital media, we called as a live chat, interviews or Zoom meetings, video conferencing, webinars or Skype for communication. So give instructions as make complaints and give suggestion. So there are many profit of speaking. So there is one is group discussion. So you, first question first is, there is the icebreaker activity, and the first activity is, you must have discussed many things with your friends, classmates in a group. It might be about going on a picnic or selecting a gift for your teacher. Okay. You must have discussed many things with your friends, classmates in a group, and it might be all about going on a picnic or selecting a gift for your teacher. So first is, what do you think are the benefits of group discussion? There are also benefits of group discussion. When we discuss in a group, so group discussion allows the participant to share their views and opinions. So there is the one of the benefit. You suppose you are the participants to share your views and opinions. Second, it allows each participants to analyze the topic or case. It allows each participant to analyze the topic or case. Third, a group discussion allows the participant to reach general consensus. So a group discussion allows the participant to share their views, opinions, any topic which they like it. And second, it allows the participant to analyze the topic or case. Or group discussion allows the participant to reach a general consensus. Second, do you think some peoples are right and some are wrong in a group discussion, and why? There may be some people are right and some are wrong in a group discussion, and why? So yes, I do think so, but generally we hold views on a topic or situation. So this view is either strength or weakened by the ongoing arguments in a group discussion. Due to confirmation bias, we tend to think that the participant who strengthened or weakened by the ongoing arguments. So due to confirmation, we tend to think that participant who strengthened our views are right. Similarly, we think of those who go against our views are wrong, and the ideal situation is that we keep an open mind and assess each argument on its own merit, but this is easier said than done. So there is the most information about he sees as second. People have different views and opinions because आता प्रत्येकाची मतं काय असतात ही वेगवेगळी असतात. सो पीपल हॅव डिफरंट व्ह्यूज अँड ओपिनियन्स अबाउट बिकॉज सो डिफरंट पर्स्पेक्टिव ॲज जॉग्रॉफिकल अँड कल्चरल. हियर वी गिव ॲज जॉग्रॉफिकल अँड कल्चरल. थर्ड, social and political. So people have different views on a social, political, geographical and cultural views as different perspective views. So complete the web and highlighting the use of group discussion. So one is done for you. So uses of group discussion. So where we use group discussion? First in job interviews. Suppose you have got 80% or 91%, but you can't speak in English in any one line. But you can't speak in English in any one line. So there may be in a job interview there is question on English. So here we see in effective classroom learning, in uses of group discussion, effective classes of learning or classroom learning. Third, in reaching consonance on real life situation, in reaching consonance on real life situation in getting admission or to prime educational institution. म्हणजे आपण एखादे इफेक्टिव लर्निंग क्लासरूममध्ये आहे तर त्याच्यामध्ये सुद्धा लँग्वेज जी आहे ती इंग्लिशमध्ये वापरली जाते. सो ब्रेन स्टॉर्मिंग ॲक्टिव्हिटीज देअर इज द ऑल्सो, बट वी सी ग्रुप डिस्कशन फर्स्ट. अ ग्रुप डिस्कशन इज अ फॉर्मल डिस्कशन. अ ग्रुप डिस्कशन इज अ फॉर्मल डिस्कशन. देर इज मे बी one of the situation he says of group discussion is a formal discussion conducted on a topic among a topic of a group of 10 or 12 participants. Eka group madhe 10 kiwa 12 participants asu shaktat. The participants analyze the topic for their respective angles and present their views and opinion. The group is on given a topic. They contemplate on it for a few minutes and then start discussion. The discussion is usually for 10 to 15 minutes. Experts listen to the members and evaluate them. Experts listen to the members and evaluate them. So group discussion called as a formal discussion and angles they respect topic for their analyze participant. Every participants analyze the topic for their respective angles and presents their views, opinions, and group is given a topic. Group discussions are usually held on topics for our kids. For example, first we called as factual. For example, plastic should be banned. Plastic should be banned. Second, social political issues. For example, moral policing or abstract. For example, conscience. Case study based, where the group discusses a case study and analyze its or offer solutions. Group discussions are one of the effective interactive method of classroom learning. They are used to select candidates for different courses or jobs by employers. They are used to gauge whether a candidate possesses certain skills so required for pursuing a particular course or a job that involve working in a group or giving opinion and solve problems together to achieve common goals. So candidates are tested. There may be examples. So candidates are tested for their knowledge, communication skill, as well as their ability to work as a part of group and to lead others towards conclusion, solution. One should be able to use his understanding of a subject. One should be able to use his understanding of a subject to give opinion on it and support his ideas with logical argument. So the general mood of the discussion decides whether the group is in favor discussion or against the continuous issues, for example subject, topic. So finally, under the supervision of evaluator, the members conclude the discussion on a general consensus. So a topic is given to participants. Procedures follows a group. Since communication is a two-way process, it is important that besides speaking, one listen to participant in the group, discussion and respond to their ideas or take them forward. You can contribute to a group discussion in some of the following ways. Helping in start, giving direction to it, making sure that everyone's views are heard and thought about so that the group moves towards some kind of agreement, and closing with a summary or a conclusion. The language of group discussion, for example, here are some expressions you can use. Perform different function during the group discussion, expressing opinion. For example, I believe, could I make a point please? It seems to me, in my opinion, I think. So these lines, expressing opinions, I believe, could I make a point please? It seems to me, I think, in my opinion. Expressing agreement, absolutely, I fully agree with, you are right. Expressing disagreement, so I am afraid, I don't agree with, I can see your point, but I am sorry, but I see it a little differently. You may have something there, but I respect your point of view, but I am sorry, I can't go along with you. When you are suggesting, I think we should, let's, don't you think we could? Why don't we? So there is the expressing views, opinions. So general, first we see procedures followed by group discussion. A topic is given to 10 participants or 12 participants, get some time and to think, form their views and opinions. Group discussion goes on, come to conclusion 10 and 15 minutes. The teacher, evaluators and panel judges the performance of each candidate. So general evaluation criteria, first, communication skill. In communication skill, there is a fluency, accuracy, concision and force of argument, body languages. Second, language competency, listening, speaking, intonation, accent. Third, grasp of the topic. Fourth, analytical skill. Fifth, reasoning skill. Sixth, leadership qualities. 7. Self-confidence. 8. Organization skill. 9. Assertive attitudes. So kind of topics for group discussion. That is also important. Kind of topics for group discussion. For example, factual, we see factual, social or political. In factual, we see plastic should be banned. Social or political issues, moral policing, an abstract topic as example, conscience, and four, case study, an account of a situation over a specific time. The ways in which you can contribute to group discussion, helping to start group discussion, giving particular direction to the discussion. Third, supporting a views which is similar to stand you have taken, denouncing a view which contradicts as your personal conviction. So leading the discussion to a broad consensus, helping to conclude the group discussion on a general note. So the language of group discussion as a expressing opinion. So I believe, I think, in my opinion, it seems to me, could I make point please? Second, expressing agreement, absolutely, I fully agree with, you are right. Expressing disagreement, I am afraid I don't agree with, I can see your point, but I respect your point of view, but I am sorry I can't go along with you on. I am sorry, but I see it a little differently. You may have something there, but suggesting, I think we should, let's, don't you think we would, and why don't we, wouldn't we? Fourth, asking for opinions. What is your opinion on and what do you feel about? I wonder what do you think about and I would like to your stand. So these examples are important when you are participants in discussion. And sixth, interrupting. I am sorry to interrupt, but excuse me, could I add something please? That is true, sorry, but 7, handling interpretation. So just a moment, please. If you would just let me finish, could I finish what I am saying? And could you wait for a minute, please? In concluding, to summarize, conclude, we can conclude by saying, so let's run quickly through the main ideas and main ideas before concluding the discussion. That is the most important to summarize and conclude. So the example, or we call it as a sample group discussion. Sample group discussion, as you have all been given a few minutes to think on your topic for today's group discussion. That is the most important one way. So you have all been given a few minutes to think on your topic for today's group discussion, and which is, do you think teenager should be given separate mobile phone? You may now begin the discussion, and who would like to start? Manisha says, I think the topic of this discussion is very relevant to all of us here. As teenager, we are so fond of our mobile phones and its different features that have become as irresistible to us. I feel mobile phones are quite necessary and they are quite helpful for educational purpose. We can get support for their various subjects just at the click of button. Anamika says, I also agree with Suhasini, because nowadays people use smartphone and they can get access to any information they want, like travel information, recipes, courses, colleges, etc. John says, yes, I would like to add to it. I don't think students use the mobile phones only for seeking useful information. They use it for entertainment too, and they listen to song, watch movies, etc. I am afraid they see unsuitable things too, so moreover, they spend long hours on a phone or मोबाईल फोन. ते काय करतात, जास्तीत जास्त जो वेळ आहे तो आपला मोबाईलवरती घालवतात. हे जॉनचं ओपिनियन आहे, व्ह्यूज आहे. यस, आय वूड लाईक टू ॲड इट. आय डोंट थिंक स्टुडंट यूज मोबाईल फोन्स ओनली फॉर सिकिंग यूजफुल इन्फॉर्मेशन. दे यूज इट फॉर एंटरटेनमेंट टू ओनली टू दे लिसन टू सॉन्ग, watch movies, etc. I am afraid they see unsuitable things too. Moreover, they spend long hours on phone. Anamika says, yes, Deepak, you are absolutely right, but I think parents have made them aware of the abuses of the mobiles. They are mature enough to understand how to use the mobile phones productively. That is the most important. He says, I think parents have made them aware of the abuses of the mobiles, and they are mature enough to understand
how to use the mobile phones productively. Ananya says, yes, all this is true, but don't you all agree that they do see unwanted things, waste their times in things so not suitable for their age group? John says, I agree with what Manjula says. It is sheer wastage of time, money and energy. Not only time, but also money and energy. Anamika says, I feel that most of the students have forgotten the basic use of mobile phones. Most of the students have forgotten the basic use of mobile phones. They have to travel long distance for tuitions and other purposes. The parents can keep a track of their children, and that is the main reason why parents have given them mobiles. John says, yes, but students have become lazy. They lack concentration. They don't read books. Same with, they don't read books. The phone keeps ringing and disturbs them now and then. Manisha says, parents' institution block some sites so that students are not able to view unwanted material, and the risk is there. But with advantages, there are disadvantages too. Relator says, all right, everyone, your time is nearly up. Could someone conclude, please? John says, taking the point into consideration, mobile is a good and useful tool, but a time period should be allotted to the student to use mobile so that students do not become couch as a potatoes, eye problems. So posture problems, psychological problems have increased. They sometimes become as violent if mobile phones are taken away from them. And that is the reality. They sometimes become violent if mobile phones are taken away from them. They can use these phones, but they should be made to them as so. Brainstorming activity here, see 169. So we see sample of group discussion on the mobile phones, and the topic is, do you agree, do you think teenagers should be given a separate mobile phone? And next you solve 169. So Ram, Asif, Rachna and Arav are participating in group discussion, and the evaluator has given them topic, teenagers are more inclined towards junk food nowadays. So write suitable dialogues for each participant and giving his or her opinion. The suitable titles are here. First, evaluator says, you have all been given a few minutes to think on your topic for today's group discussion, which is teenagers are more inclined towards junk food. You may now begin with discussion. Who would like to start? First, we see, as Ram says, I think I will. In my opinion, it is very true. Junk food leads as obesity, and we find more obese teenager around nowadays. Asif says, your own view, you write some incidents. I'm afraid I can't agree with that statements. Most of the teenager in our colleges look quite fit and active. Some persons are agree with you, some person may be disagree with you. So Asif is disagree or agree. So I am afraid I can't agree. He is disagree with that statement. Most of the teenagers in our college look quite fit and active. RO says, I think we must see the issues in a wider perspective. The inclination towards junk food among teenagers is a worldwide phenomenon. And one can't jump to a conclusion by just looking around and citing a few examples in our college. Rachna says, it seems to me that Ram made a valid point. Teenager world over are inclined toward junk food and it possesses a great threat. I suggest the teenagers change their food habit and resort more to healthy snacks. Our tradition offers a wide variety of such snacks. Evaluator says, please conclude. And RO conclude, we can conclude by saying that our teenagers are inclined to junk food. They must change their food habit. It is a high time they switch to healthy snacks. We need healthy citizens to take our country forward. So, there is information about as a junk food that is the important in your life. And this is the reality of our in everyday situation. He says, read the following statements. If you are agree, say yes. And if you don't agree, say no. So state the reason for your opinion. It is not possible to guess the topic for group discussion. Then there is no need to prepare. So, topics for the group discussion are mainly chosen from things and happening around of us. So, we must keep our minds open and receptive to the happening around us. So, knowledge thus received and the opinions and views we form as about each subject and will prove to be our preparation for the group discussion. So, there may be as a no. Okay. Statement kaya hai? First, it is not possible to guess the topic for group discussion and there is no need to prepare. And the answer is no. Why? The reason of the no is topic for group discussion are mainly chosen from things happening around us. So we must keep our minds open, respective the happening of around us and the knowledge thus received and the opinions and views we form about each such topics will prove to be our preparation for the group discussion. Second statement, always have discussion with your family, friends on different topics. Always have discussion with your family, friends and on different topics. Answer is yes. If you agree, you call as yes. If you disagree, you call as no. But there is a reason you give. For example, we may be wrong in our opinion, views, constant discussion with family and friends. So help us form the right sort of views and opinion. We may be wrong in our opinion, views, constant discussion with family, friends. Help us form as the right sort of views and opinions. Third statement, you must aim to get noticed by the evaluator. We must be noticed mainly as noted. So there is the most important. You must aim to get noticed by the evaluator and there may be answer is no or yes. So forget the evaluator and looks at the participant while discussion. While discussion, that is the most important when you discuss some views, opinions. You must have aims to get noticed by the evaluators. And no, reason is no, we must get noticed mainly by the force of our agreement and our active involvement in the discussion. Evaluators are experienced to assess our analytical powers, assertive approach, and any deliberate efforts to outshine other participants will do more harm than good. Fourth statement, forget the evaluator and look at the participant file discussion. The evaluator is a passive observer and discussion happens only among the participants. So glancing at the evaluator often could be treated as a sign of your distracted mind. Fifth statement, you should raise your voice to be heard by everyone and speak for a long time to show your knowledge. No. Reason, our voice should neither to be high or nor to be low. Our voice should be neither be too high or to be low. So raising one's voice much more than necessary will create the impression of rabble rouser and our grasp of the topic so must come out naturally through the novelty of our agreement and brevity concision. Must be watchword a long and verbose argument will surely produce a negative product. 6. You should always take the opportunity to beginning as to begin the argument or discussion. No. Reason, though initiating a discussion shows our leadership qualities, an overzealous approach may at times sow against us. Statement 7. Take a strong position, views and defend it till the end. So no, and reason is, if another participant contradicts our views with sound reasoning, you must consent to it, and taking a strong position beforehand may restrict us from considering other point of view. Next statement, do not keep waiting for your turn to speak. So you have to be alert and quick. We must be alert and quick. We must seize the opportunity to speak, and being too passive may even deny its a chance and present our views. Next statement, listening to others also plays an important role in a group discussion. Listening to others, not only speaking to others, but listening to others also plays an important role in a group discussion. When you listen somebody's, then you are words or you are speaking listened by. So listening to others also plays an important role in a group discussion. Yes, so listening to others is a crucial elements in a group discussion. It helps us to formulate new perspectives and modify our views in the course of discussion. So you must interrupt a person if you do not agree to his opinion. Everyone has a right to hold individual opinion. Moreover, interruption as denies the person the opportunities to complete his views. We can take up the counter argument as soon as he finishes his views. Next, shows your leadership skills by being assertive, not aggressive. So reason of this is yes. Assertiveness is a positive trait. It is a sign of leadership quality. We can be assertive by the force of our argument and the conviction we have in our views. Aggression, on the other hand, will only expose our untamed personality. And last one is, participating in a group discussion also means helping everyone to reach consensus in spite of difference opinion. Yes, so group discussion helps us realizes that there are other possible views and opinions. Receptive and accommodative mind is as prerequisite for anyone who participate in a group discussion. Moreover, the candidate must be able to feel the pulse of discussion, and this in turn will help to reach the consensus. Next, group discussion has to unravel the following personality traits in person. So personality traits are critical thinking, leadership skill, effective communication, and analytic power. So match the following. For example, as a discuss, give special importance or value something in a speaking or writing. Argue, say something again a number of times. Deliberate, express views, opinions in a heated, angry way. Reiterate, engage in long, careful consideration and emphasize. To talk about a subject with someone and to tell each other your ideas and opinion. Your ideas and opinion. So first we see discuss, to talk about subject with someone, to tell each other with your ideas and opinions. So today we are going, I hope you have understood very well. Thank you very much.